Credit for new ideas is the foundation on which scientific careers are built, and scientists compete intensely to publish important findings first. On the one hand, this can be beneficial if it incentivizes new discoveries and accelerates the pace of innovation. On the other, the pressure to establish priority may lead scientists to cut corners in order to publish quickly. This paper investigates whether competition lowers the quality of scientific work. To help fix ideas, consider the following simple model. Suppose the research process consists of two stages. In the first, a scientist chooses a project, but must make an upfront investment in order to pursue it. The greater the level of investment, the higher the probability that she successfully starts the project and proceeds to stage two. Here, she decides how long to work on the project before publishing her findings, and we assume that longer maturation periods lead to higher quality outputs. Now, suppose that multiple scientists are working on the same project, and that the one who publishes first receives the most credit. This induces a trade-off between project quality and the fear of being scooped. The longer the scientist allows her project to mature, the greater the risk that a competitor publishes first. As a result, the threat of competition leads scientists to publish faster than they otherwise would and lowers scientific quality. So, which projects are likely to be the most competitive? Returning to stage one, suppose projects differ in their ex-ante potential. Some are high potential because they are of central importance to their field, while others are marginal and therefore low potential. Completing a high potential project brings greater professional acclaim, leading researchers to invest more in pursuing them and increasing the level of competition. Thus, the model's key prediction is a paradoxical one. It is precisely those projects that are deemed most important by the scientific community that will generate the most competition and, therefore, be executed most quickly and with the lowest quality. To assess these dynamics empirically, the authors turn to structural biology. Scientists in this field map the three-dimensional structure of biological macromolecules, most commonly proteins, and this research plays a key role in drug and vaccine development. These structures are often solved using X-ray crystallography. Scientists distill a concentrated solution of the protein into crystals, subject it to X-ray beams, and record the resulting diffraction pattern. To solve for the protein's structure, they then construct a proposed atomic model and iteratively adjust this model in order to match its simulated diffraction data with the experimental data. Does competition affect the quality of research in this setting? The authors make use of a data source uniquely well-suited to answering this question, the Protein Data Bank. The PDB is a worldwide repository of biological macromolecules, providing near-universal coverage of structure discoveries. For each entry, the PDB records a number of variables that allow the authors to test their model's predictions. These include measures of competition, maturation, potential, and, crucially, objective science-based measures of quality. These quantify the goodness of fit between researchers' models and the experimental data, and spending more time and effort in the process of iteratively refining a model can translate to higher quality. So, what do the authors find? First, they show that high-potential projects are more competitive. The PDB assigns each protein to a similarity cluster based on its structure, and the number of deposits within a cluster is an indication of the crowdedness or competition for a given protein. This figure shows that high potential projects are more crowded. Relative to low potential ones, they have about 30% more deposits in their cluster. The key finding, however, is that relative to low potential projects, high potential projects have shorter maturation periods and quality measures that are about 0.7 standard deviations lower. In other words, the most important projects are executed most quickly and with the lowest quality. Now, the model suggests that important projects have low quality because scientists rush to publish first. However, it's also possible that high potential proteins are simply more complex and difficult to solve with high quality. To address this, the authors provide several pieces of evidence to show that the results are, in fact, driven by competition. First, as seen before, high potential projects are completed more quickly. If anything, we would expect maturation periods to be longer if these structures are more complex. Second, the negative relationship between potential and quality is mitigated when scientists are insulated from competitive pressures. To show this, the paper compares structural genomic, or SG, researchers and non-SG researchers. SG groups are federally funded consortia, and qualitative evidence suggests these scientists are less exposed to competitive pressures relative to their university or industry-based counterparts. And the results show meaningful differences in behavior between the two groups. While non-SG structures exhibit the same negative relationship between potential and maturation, and potential and quality, SG researchers spend longer on high potential projects, and the negative relationship between potential and quality is substantially attenuated. This suggests that competitive pressures are the driving force behind the results. Thus, in this context, the empirical patterns are consistent with the model's predictions. The race to publish first leads researchers to release their work prematurely, and it is precisely the most important questions that are most competitive and therefore most poorly executed. Note, however, this does not imply that reducing competition, for example, by distributing credit more equally between the first and second teams to publish, is necessarily optimal. Doing so may reduce the pressure to publish quickly, but at the cost of reducing incentives to pursue important projects in the first place. To read more on this topic, you can check out the paper's references to other related work. This includes research on the importance of credit and priority in scientific careers, those concerned with the role of competition, and finally, papers studying innovation races.